For most of us, exercise is something of a four-letter word. You mention exercise, and most people's reaction is, ah, yuck. We have visions of having to pump iron for hours in the gym, or having to run marathons, and just quietly, I absolutely hate running. But here's a question for you. Statistically speaking, what one thing is the strongest predictor of an impending heart attack? Is it high cholesterol? No. Is it high triglycerides? Well, that's really bad, but no. Is it high blood sugar levels? Also really bad, but no. None of those are it. The experts will tell you that the single most reliable predictor of an impending heart attack is a lack of physical exercise. Many of us, in fact, most people today, live a sedentary lifestyle. My workday is largely spent sitting on my backside in front of a computer screen. We have cars or public transport to take us places, couriers to carry heavy things for us. Even children these days are mostly dropped off at their school by their parents in a car, whereas when I was young, we all walked to school. The point is that there's been a significant drop in the natural level of exercise that most people do. But here's the exciting news about exercise. You don't have to become a marathon runner to add years to your life and life to your years. Moderate exercise, a half hour's brisk walk at least three times a week, if you can do it most days, that's even better, is enough to significantly reduce your risk of heart disease, stroke, and diabetes. I know, you don't have time, do you? Well, let me ask you, do you have time to get sick? Do you have time to spend months off work because of your heart attack? Of course, that may never happen, because the most common result of a heart attack is death. Come on, you have an amazing body, and it's only a small amount of moderate exercise that's needed to get you fit and healthy. I reckon that's good news. So get up and get going. In any case, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19, you should know that your body is a temple for the Holy Spirit that you received from God and that lives in you. You don't own yourselves. Come on, look after your body. That's God's word. Fresh for you today.